안녕하세요. Let's try to make Korean sentence using subject, object, and verb. 할인바와 I love BTS. 나는 BTS를 사랑해. If you can see in our sentence structure, 매력보다 이용 subject, subject particle, object, object particle. Always remember na after po ng subject, meron po tayong particle na dinadagdag after po ng subject and after po ng object. We studied this before, so you can check the video in our last class. And then yung sa verb is nasa huli. Ang dahilan po ay we have to conjugate to past, present, future. Halimbawa, so I love BTS. But you can say, minahal ko yung BTS. Then, naman BTS를 사랑했어. So nagpo-form, nag-change po yung form. Pagka present, 사랑해. Pagka future, 사랑할 거야. Let's try another example. I love adobo. 나는 adobo를 좋아해. So, it's up to you. Kung ginusto mo, nagustuhan mo yung adobo, then past tense. 나는 adobo를 좋아했어. 좋아해 and 좋아할 거야. Let's try another example. Joshua is studying Korean language. Joshua는 한국어를 공부해요. Or mag-aaral pa lang siya, 공부할 거예요. 그래야 po, ito po yung naging word order po natin or yung sentence structure. Now, there is one thing that you have to remember. Sa paggawa po ng Korean sentence, lagi po tayong merong formal and informal, which means meron po tayong 존댓말 and 반말. 그래야 po, pagka 존댓말, pagka formal, meron pong ibang sentence na ginagamit natin and pagka informal, another sentence po yung ginagamit natin. Halimbawa, I love BTS. Pagka sa formal, 저는 BTS를 사랑합니다. Or 사랑해요. But if you make it in 반말, 나는 BTS를 사랑해. So that's the difference in making Korean sentence. All you have to know is yung sentence pattern, the order na ginagawa po natin. So we'll be making more exercises. Pagbibigay po tayo ng mas maraming mga samples and examples, and I hope you can make your own sentences. So, kindly check the comment down below, yung mga description na nilagay po namin, and feel free to ask anything that you want para po makita po natin yung progress na pinag-aaralan po natin. Maraming po salamat, and see you in our next challenge. Bye-bye!